piano is quite a high, you know, society instrument in a way, and it's very expensive, and especially a grand piano, and I still feel that when I'm coming into a concert space, people might be shivering a little bit because they think that I'm doing something weird to their instrument, but I think I'm just using the whole potential of the instrument in general. Prepared piano is an interesting way of using a piano. Of course, at some point you feel like, yeah, okay, we heard that and that's the trick and stuff like that. But for me, it's a kind of very interesting element that comes on top of the piano, because the piano is an instrument that combines a lot of diverse elements. It has strings, it has hammers that are making it to a kind of percussion instrument. Then it has a huge resonance body. When you press the sustain pedal, there is a reverb in there that you can control, and it has anyways a lot of resonance in the instrument. So you have very low bass, you have 88 keys. In total, you have a lot of opportunities. But when I played it without preparation, I felt that there is a kind of drum aspect missing. So for me, the kind of like force full drive was sometimes, you know, only achievable by using a band, but I wanted to achieve that without a band. Mostly from 9 years old, I tried to avoid playing piano because I, in a way, it was not really a cool instrument at that time. So I decided to use synthesizers. And from there onwards, I went through a lot of diverse activities with music. I did music for films already when I was 18. I went into a hip hop band, I was rapping in that band, and I was producing. I got signed to Sony Music, and we toured one tour with the Fantastischen Vier. I went into electronic music because I felt in electronic music I have a lot of freedom to do whatever I like to do, and there's nobody asking me about, yeah, where is the beautiful singer. Then suddenly the piano was creeping from the side into my life back again, and in a way that's maybe how a life circle goes. You, at some point, you have to return to a place that you always wanted to avoid. For percussive sounds, I'm using these sticks, and they are normally used by piano tuners. They are called mutes, and I'm using those, for example, for creating percussion sounds here inside. And depending on the position, you get like all sorts of overtones in here, like this as well. You see, every position changes actually the sound. So these are awesome, and I'm using those very, very strong super magnets. And then I'm using these art erasers, a kind of wooden block sound. Yeah, and then I'm using these pieces from a rubber, from a bicycle. And I have this children's tambourine that I'm using a lot in this area. And And what I like about this is it nearly sounds like an African kind of vibe. In Africa, when I was there last year in Nairobi, people were adding a lot of these like bells on their instruments, so they create a kind of, or bottle caps, so they create this kind of rattling on top. Random things that are happening are very, very important for me, because they force the piano to be different than a normal piano. And that is for me the most fun in the whole thing. It's a little bit like speed dating. You just go in, you just, you know, you grab everything, you just talk to the instrument for a while, and then you take everything out and that's it. And then you, the next day, you play with a different one. John Cage said, it's always important if you have a random event in your music, it's always important which kind of questions you are asking. I think I'm asking my fans or my audience that they should come along with me, and I hope I can keep the promise that they make a kind of trip through sound and through music that they maybe find interesting. I'm inspired by human beings a lot, because I always think that I'm going on tour because I want to meet people rather than play in a concert. And then the concert is maybe the cream on top of the cake. So in a way, I have the impression that my performance is helping me to learn more about the world.